Hello and welcome. We're in conversation with none other than the Union Finance Minister, Mr. Arun Jaitley. Sir, what a pleasure giving time to CNBC TV18 as always, sir. So the first off, a mega recapitalization plan announced for the public sector banks. Most of the big banks, you know, I mean, their stocks have really skyrocketed. There has been a continuous rally, so to speak. But one query that is doing the rounds is people just want to understand this better. So how are you going to structure the recapitalization bonds? Because we do understand that a large part of it may be completely offline, sir. That is basically it may not impact your fiscal deficit numbers, so to speak, and which again is a positive, sir.
Well, we have not spoken a final word on this. It's obvious that 76,000 crores is going to be raised from the market or being provided by the budget. That's 58,000 crores once we bring down government equity down to 52%, and another 18,000 is the leftover of the Indradhanush. Now that 76,000 is clear. Now on the bonds we have multiple options, and those multiple options are all being examined, and those the best option out of that we will explore. I don't think whether it adds to the fiscal deficit or doesn't add to the fiscal deficit in this case will be the primary reason itself. An investment of this kind, which adds to the government debt, is something that the markets are willing to accommodate, that the rating agencies are willing to accommodate. Because in the last three and a half years, we've been busy fixing multiple problems with the economy. And one of the unfinished agenda, of course, has been the banking system. And you had to take a major step, not a baby step, to resolve that issue. And that's what the government has decided.
Right, sir. So hopefully the scheme should be announced before December. So we understand that looking at 1.35 lakh crores, you know,
the first. See, one thing we are clear that we'd like to do it at the earliest. You're right, it should be done at the very outset because the spread over of this has to take place between two financial years. So part of it will be before the 31st of March and a part post 31st of March itself. We'll split it into two financial years. That's what we've decided. Now, the modalities will involve what is the nature of the bonds. Should the government per se do it, or should we do it by some other mechanism, which are also options which have been explored in the past by governments. And even when it comes to raising money from the market, you don't go on day one. You have to spread it over a period of time, otherwise the market itself collapses. And therefore, you have to choose the best timing of your choice.
Right, sir. So you're speaking about banks raising money from the market. So obviously, we understand as of now that the additional strength will come in through the recapitalization bonds, and after that, they'll be looking at kind of diluting government stake. You know, if you look at the top banks as of now, they are, you know, close to around 55 to 56% in terms of the government shareholding. I suppose they may not be the ones immediately looking for this kind of capital
you
relief.
See, these are all minor details which will be worked out. I'm not in a position to make a comment on them today on day one. But as the Department of Financial Services, we'll examine it in the department and how the spread is to take place as far as offloading in the market is concerned. The market is quite at its boom period at the moment, and even if you have to divest some shares, this is the right time to divest. And if you are going to recapitalize the bank stocks are moving up, therefore this may also be the right time to divest the bank stocks.
Right, sir. So, at the cost of sounding it's slightly repetitive, I may just raise this question again. So, so what we have done basically is that the entire support is coming through the issuance. Possible issue, you know, likely issuance of recap bonds, as well as the market mechanism, and a bit of the additional, the existing
budgetary
support.
You understood it rightly.
No additional budgetary support because we have the bonds and the market mechanism to take care of the needful. Sir, also we have spoken about the fact the government has announced that there will be a differentiated approach in terms of, you know, providing this capital
support. You see, that's what the Secretary of Financial Services mentioned yesterday. That's what we've decided. The criteria will be fixed and will be publicly announced. There will be no discretions. Discretions will be exercised on basis of some objective criteria itself. as to which are the banks which are to be supported. And therefore, you just keep sinking money into banks which produces no results is certainly not the object of the government. It has to be utilized effectively.
Right, sir. Right, sir. So also we understand that this requirement of 2.11 lakh crores, this kind of support also takes into account the provisioning requirements for banks in terms of the additionalities as well as the capital growth requirements, sir?
At the moment, it probably will take care substantially of these two.
Right, sir. Right, sir. Any numbers that you can give us in terms of 2.11?
No, you see, the whole scheme will be worked out. It's the policy which we've announced yesterday. Please give us some breathing time for that.
Right, sir. So also a big mega package in terms of 7 lakh crores being announced for the road sector. We understand that out of this 5.35 lakh crores spend will be on the Bharat Mala. This entire thing is being funded by the options stated out by the government. So there will be, again, no requirement of any additional budgetary support on that, sir, if I may ask.
You see, this is being funded by either the budgetary support or monies raised from the market. And a lot of these are also going to be, there will be asset recirculation. As announced yesterday in the presentation itself, a lot of projects which have already been completed on a TOT basis will now be available for an asset recirculation so that more revenues will be available to the government.
Right, right. So also coming back to the banking issue, sir, 12 places under NCLT right now, 29 more awaited. 13 December, I understand, is the timeline as to we'll know, you know, whether there's a resolution or it's coming under NCLT. How do you see this resolution process panning out?
Do you think it could be
a long haul?
So far, I think they're maintaining the timelines, to be fair to the NCLT and to the resolution process itself. I think it's begun well. Secondly, it's also changed the whole relationship between the debtor and the creditor. The debtor is no longer chasing the creditor with a begging bowl, please return my money. The relationship has changed. Those who default and persistently default now can be thrown out of their companies on day one. You can't be a defaulter and continuing to be in control. You can't enjoy the fruits of default. I think the new rules of the game are being laid down. And you already have some of the companies, at least some which are asset rich and which are already going manufacturing units, the steel units, for example. From what I read in the newspapers, there are multiple bidders for them. And that's, I think, a very good sign itself.
Right, sir. Right, sir. So you also mentioned yesterday that going forward, I mean, the announcement of the recap plan could be the phase one, possibly in the phase two, you know, we will undertake further banking reforms.
You see, I think that we need to avoid the kind of situation which took place. The situation which took place was, first you lend indiscriminately, then you hide the real position. And then you go so much on the back foot that you stop giving any further loans. So economic activity itself starts suffering. I don't think this is a cycle. And this is a cycle which I inherited. And this is a cycle which we'll like to continue in the larger interest of the economy itself. And therefore, public sector banks, except for the fact that their equity is held in majority by the government, must function as competitive units, take decisions on commercial considerations, and discharge their obligation to the best of their ability. Now, what are the norms under which these banks are going to function? As it is, political interference in the functioning of the banks is something which we brought an end to. Professionalizing the boards, we've done a lot better than our predecessors itself. And I do hope once we announced some reforms as far as banks are concerned, on a later, you see, I had already announced consolidation.
Absolutely, I was just going to come to that.
But consolidation, once you are going through this phase of capital induction and strengthening the banks, the consolidation exercise can come later in point of time rather than prior in point of time.
Right, sir. So, say around 4 to 6 months for things to settle down.
I'm not going to bind myself into timeline limits because let's see how it fans itself out.